Okay, so first let's define what is risk management or what is risk. No. So when we say risk, we are referring to the exposure to uncertainty or danger resulting to changes in the expected return in a given investment. No? Okay lang. So kung yung risk sana na yun, eh, becomes favorable to us. But what if it is unfavorable? Diba? So the reason why we have to manage our risk. So basically, the risk can be divided into two, or classified into two. So one is the systematic risk. The other one is the unsystematic risk. So when you see systematic risk, sometimes it is called non-controllable risk or undiversifiable risk. So this is something that beyond the control of the company or even the industry, no? So which means that all industries are affected by this systematic risk. So may mga examples natin ito. One is of course yung interest rate risk, no? So we cannot control the interest rate. Eh, pagka tumaas ka ang interest rate sa US, damay tayo kagad, no? Biglang babaksak yung stock market, not only here in the Philippines, but also in other countries. And then you have the unsystematic risk. Then these sometimes are called controllable risk. So this is within the control of the company. Something that is within the jurisdiction and can be avoided by the company. And then, yun nga sinasabi rin dito sa definition, this type of risk is unique to a given security. No? So particular siya dun sa industry. So meaning, if you are affected, no, a particular company or particular industry is affected by this risk, then some industries may not be affected by that risk. No? So halimbawa, yung pwede natin bigay natin dyan, yung business risk. No? The business risk is particular to the company, to the industry, but not to the entire industries. No? Kasi marami tayong klaseng industry. Meron tayong mining, meron tayong service, meron tayong retail. No? So maraming klase ng industries tayo. But when you say unsystematic, this is particular to the industry or perhaps even particular to the company. So what is risk management? So this involves identifying events that could have an adverse effect on the financial position of the firm, and then taking actions to prevent or minimize the damage caused by those events. Because actually risk, we cannot totally avoid this, no? We cannot totally avoid them. Because there are two types of risk, no? The systematic and the unsystematic risk. So we cannot totally avoid them. What we can avoid is actually the unsystematic risk, not this one. Yan. So this one is the one that we can avoid. But this one, the systematic, we cannot. No, we cannot avoid that because all industries are affected. But somehow we can manage to handle those risks by minimizing only, but you cannot totally eradicate them, but you can minimize them, no? So how do you minimize? Yeah, those risk and return natin, di ba? One way of minimizing the risk is by diversification. But anyway, that is out of the context of our lecture, no? Kaya medyo iiwan ko yan. But yun yung reason nun. We can diversify to minimize the risk. So what is the basic risk management? So the basic risk management is actually insurance. So it may be a life, non-life, or yung mga health insurance. But this insurance or this tool in risk management, they actually evolved. No? Dumami na dumami yung mga derivative tools natin or derivative instruments natin. That to the point it becomes so sophisticated that that once you are not able to manage them, once na pumutok siya, no, the term is pumutok, o nagkakaroon na ng crisis, bale, no? Just like what happened in 2007, 2008, no? Yung tinatawag natin na subprime crisis, no? Because of the mortgage. So the codes involved in risk management, no? It can be applied to oil futures, commodity futures, options, and swaps. So later on, one by one, we'll discuss natin sila. Okay, so example tayo of managing the risk, no? Let's say we have Plastics Incorporated. This is a manufacturing firm, no? So Plastics Incorporated manufactures dashboards, interior board, and interior door panels, and other plastic components used by auto companies. So petroleum is the key material for plastic, and it has 3-year contract with an auto company for door panels for $60 each. And then the price of oil is $120 per barrel. So what will happen if the price of oil went up? Definitely, because one of the costs of the company is the oil. So once the price of this oil went up, so that is a disadvantage on their part. Now it will increase their cost, so thereby it will decrease their profitability. But what if the oil, no, the price of oil goes down? That is an advantage to them because the cost is lesser now, and then the chances are the profit will be higher. Now assume that the firm enters into a contract. So this time they will enter into a contract because of the volatility, let's say, of the price of oil. So they will enter into a contract to lock in a 3-year supply of oil at a guaranteed price of $120 per barrel, and the cost of the guarantee is zero. So if they will enter into a contract, so meaning they are trying to lock in, no, or they will lock in the price of oil at $120. So would that be good or bad for the company? Simply, it depends, no? It depends. So if the price of the oil now will increase, so that would be an advantage to them because they peg their price at $120. So kahit tumakya po yun ng $150, $200, because they peg it at $120, they will buy it at $120. But what about if it goes down? Siyempre, disadvantage sa kanila yan. Kasi bumaba. But since they have the contract, they still have to buy it at $120. But the goodness of which is that if, let's say, the price of oil goes down, no, at least they already anticipated that they can pay or will pay at $120 per barrel. So hindi sila nagulat. So meaning, it is already part of the cash flow of the company. It is already part of the budget of the company. So if it goes down, maaring sayang nga, sayang. Kasi instead of availing of that low price, but because of that contract, $120, they still have to pay at $120. But like what I said, the good news is that they were able to budget it already. Unlike for the kung 120 siya, biglang umakyat, yun ang malaking advantage sa kanila. Kasi instead of buying that at a high price, they still buy that at 120. Yun nga lang, pagka bumaba, they still have to buy it at 120. Pero yun nga, ang kagandahan doon, nakabudget na rin sila ron sa 120. No? And actually, in that context, doon pumapasok yung derivatives, no? So we can apply yung mga forward contracts, futures, options, no? But the swaps, we cannot, no? Kasi in swaps, it is more on the interest rate. But swap is also a derivative. If, let's say, you have a liability and you have to pay, of course, interest, no? So what is expectation regarding the price of the stock if that happens dito sa company na to? Now the price of the stock will increase if, of course, no, let's say bumaba, nagkaroon sila ng profit, no, kumita sila, and then of course if the WACC decreases, no. Pero sa bagay, hindi to part talaga ng lesson natin, but we are discussing this only as a part of what is the impact of the movement of price, no. So syempre yung movement ng price niyan, halimbawa tumaas nga yung oil, still we peg at 120. So increase, nag-increase yung ating profitability dyan, no? Kasi hindi natin na-absorb yung high price for the oil. Okay, so let's go to derivatives. So derivatives are securities whose values are determined by market price of some other asset. So take note that the derivatives in itself does not have a value, but it derives its value in the underlying asset. Okay, may sinasabi itong some other asset. Or we may say also underlying asset. Now, what are the underlying assets? So this may be the stocks, no? It may be bonds, it may be on the forex or commodities, no? So pwede natin gawin yan mga underlying assets. Huh? So what are the kinds of derivatives? So one, we have the options, then we have the futures and the swaps. And then actually meron pang isa dyan, yung forwards, no? Hindi lang nakalagay dito. Yung forwards and futures kasi almost the same, no? The difference only between the two is the futures is actually in the standardized market. No, formal yung market ng futures. Like yung forward, it is not. No, and then the futures, you only yung difference lang ng price ang dinideliver. Unlike in the forward contracts, the underlying asset has to be delivered. So the instruments used in derivatives are highly leveraged, that small miscalculations lead to huge losses. So yun yung nagiging problema ng derivatives, no? So a little miscalculation, it will involve a huge loss. So the reason why some analysts would prefer or saying that insurance, which being the basic, is still better than derivatives. Kaya lang when it comes to derivatives naman, actually, it tries to magnify also the increase in profit. Yun nga lang, pagka nag-loss niya, pagka nagkaroon ng miscalculation, losses are also huge. No? That is the counterpart of having a higher income using derivatives. Okay, now let's go to an option. So, option, a contract that gives its holder the right, but not the obligation to buy or sell an asset at some predetermined price within a specified period of time. So it's important to remember, it does not obligate its owner to take action. So it's not an obligation, but it is only a right. No? So it merely gives the owner the right to buy or sell an asset. So to make this clearer, no? So let me discuss this in using word. Gagawa tayo ng parang ano, parang graph, no? Para makikita ninyo yung ibig kong sabihin. Sinave ko na to last time, nawala eh. So let's see, we have the line, ano yan? Ito yung ating y-axis. Okay, so let's say this line, no? We have this line. Okay, so this is for the earning one. So let's have the call option, which is the right to buy, no? This is a call option, which is the right to buy. So let's say they have the exercise price. Now let's see the exercise price. It's 100. So the exercise price is at this point. Okay, so yan yung ating exercise price. No, 100 pesos. No? So that is the exercise price. So you will enter into a contract, for example, to buy the underlying asset at 100 6 months from now. No? So ganun siya. So 6 months from now, huh, they entered into a contract that they will pay the item or the underlying asset at 100 pesos. So we have the exercise or the expiration date, which is 6 months. And this one is the exercise price. Now let's say the actual price after 6 months went up to 120 pesos. No? Went up to 120 pesos. So ibig sabihin lang yung class, even if the underlying asset, no, the price of the underlying asset went up to 120, we are not obligated to buy that at 120, but we can exercise the right to buy at 100. So kaya right to buy eh. So meaning, we will exercise our right to buy at 100 even if the price of the underlying asset is 120. No? Now let's say the price, instead of going up, it went down. Maybe 50 pesos siya. No? So this time, we will not exercise our right to buy. Now because we will just let the right to buy to expire or lapse, and then instead we will buy them at 50 pesos in the market. Okay? So again, if the price of the underlying asset went down to 50, you will not exercise your right to buy. So sulat natin dito para mas maliwanag ulit. No? At 120, exercise your right to buy. Okay, but at 120, tama, at then at 1, at 50, will not exercise your right to buy. Okay, so ganyan ang mangyayari, bale. Liwanag ba yung class? But whether the price goes up to 120 or goes down to 50, we have to pay the premium. No, siyempre may premium yan. Babayaran natin yan. So let's say meron tayong premium na 5 pesos per share. No? Per unit of the underlying asset. We have to pay for the option premium. Maliwanag ba yan? Class? Hello? Hello,
sir.
Okay, maliwanag yan, ha? Okay, next, we have the put option. Option. And that was to write pa rin. By the way, class, no? Dito sa call option na to, class, now, if let's say we are the one buying the call option, now, if we are the one buying the call option, we are expecting that the price of the underlying asset will go up. No? We are expecting, huh? That the price of the underlying asset will go up. Now, someone has to sell, of course, the option, the call option. So the seller of the call option, we are the buyer, but the seller of the call option is expecting that the price of the underlying asset will go down. Kaya magkaiba yung ating perception. Tayo as the buyer of the call option is expecting that the price will go up. And then the seller of the call option is expecting that the price of the underlying asset will go down. Ha? Okay ba yun, ha? So, dito naman nasa put option tayo, no? Put option. Okay. So, let's say, bagawin natin ng konti yung price naman natin. Ah, kaya lang baliktad pala to, no? So, pag ganito naman siya. So, let's say ganito naman siya, no? Yan. So, wag niyo muna yung hindi pa explain ko siya, no? So, let's say this time, you are the seller naman of certain underlying asset. So, let's say maglagay naman tayo ng coffee na lang. Coffee bean. No, coffee bean, salimbawa. Kasi kayo yung farmer. So, sabi mo ganun, I'm going to harvest the coffee beans in 6 months. Sabi mo ganun. But I cannot sell this at a low price. Lower than 100, sabi mo ganun. I cannot sell my coffee beans below 100. Because if I will sell it below 100, lugi ako, sabi mo ganun. But at 100, okay lang yan, sabi mo. And then I will have a decent profit for that. So you will enter into a put option contract. So this time, you will buy put option. So the put option is that you have the right to sell, no? Because you're trying to lock in at a particular selling price, which is 100. So even if it goes down to 50, you can still sell that at 100. No? But if the price of the coffee bean in 6 months, let's say, becomes 120 pesos, so this time you will not exercise, no? Dito lalabas will not. Will not exercise your right to sell. Okay, nang siya. Ayaw umakyat. Katapin ng konti class, ha, para makita niyo ng buo. Ang hirap pagka nandito klas, ano? Basta ito, nakatutok yung 100 dito, ha? Dito sa point na yan. So, ganyan siya lalabas. No, you will not, at 120, will not exercise your right to sell. Kasi, ba't mo i-exercise yung right mo ng selling? Yung price umakyat sa 120. In-expect mo nga lang eh, 100 din, no? Sabi mo, 100 lang kayak ng pagbentaan. Pero umakyat ng 120. So, this time, you will not exercise your right to sell. Then, instead, you will let the option to expire, the put option to expire. No? And then sell it at 120. Okay? But now let's say that the price, no, instead of going out up, it went down to 50. Bumaba sa 50. So this time we'll exercise your right to sell. Kasi bumaba sa 50, so meaning you will exercise your right to sell at 100 pesos even if the price went down to 50. Now, in either way, now whether the price goes up or goes down, again, you have to pay for the premium. Now, for each unit, no, let's say per kilo ba yan or per sack ba yan or kaya per stock, you know, no? So, you have to pay for the premium. So, again, if you're buying the right to sell or buying the put option, then someone also has to sell, no, the put option para magkaiba yung inyong concept. Because otherwise, this will not materialize if there is no buyer and seller of the put option. So someone has to buy the put option, then someone has to sell the put option. But us, being the buyer of the put option, we are expecting that the price of the underlying asset will go down. But the seller of the put option is expecting that the price of the underlying asset will go up. No? So magkaiba yung concept natin doon. Para yung isa doon, magiging isa mong loss. Okay? Maliwanag ba yung class?
Sir, yes. Sali po parehas na situation, magbabayad po tayo ng premium.
Premium, yes. Kailangan magbayad tayo because it is a contract. Kasi otherwise, walang magbibenta sa atin. Diba? So if you are buying the put option, then someone is selling the put option. This is the same thing with call option. If you are buying the call option, then someone is selling the call option. Clear ba yan?
Yes po, sir.
Okay, so yan yung tinatawag nating option, no? I-save ko siya ulit, no? Lagi ko sinisave to, kaya lang lagi nawawala. Baka na i-save ko sa ibang file. Okay, so yan tayo, no? Okay, yan yung call option, no? So these are some of the terminologies that I already explained, no? The call option, the put option, then the exercise price, and then you have the option price, no, option contracts, market price. But this one we will discuss later when I have the table already. And then you have the expiration date, and based on the example is 6 months. And then you have the exercise value, that is a difference, no, between the current price and the strike price. So you have to determine, syempre, current price, no, tsaka yung strike price natin, for you to determine if you're going to exercise your right to sell or your right to buy. And then we have the covered option. So this is a option written against stock held in an investor's portfolio. No? So it may not only be related to stock, but the underlying asset. But what does it mean when it is covered? So when it is covered, ibig sabihin nun, let's say in a short selling. You know what is short selling, by the way, class? You know what is short selling in the stock market? Anyone? Sige, kung wala, ganito yung short selling na sinasabi natin, no? So, let's say the price of the particular stock is going down. No? The price of the particular stock is going down. But you do not have that stock. No, you do not have the stock. So, what you will do is to sell the stock first at a higher price. No? And then when the price of that stock goes down, you will buy. Not to cover the selling. So, ibig sabihin lang doon, based din dito sa sinasabi natin na to, pagka-COVID, nag-short sell ka na meron ka ng stock. No? Meron ka ng stock. So, you are covering your short selling. But if you do not have, no, the stock, and then you will buy at a lower price, so, yun ang pang-cover natin doon sa short selling natin, doon sa selling na ginawa natin. Kasi when we say COVID, you already have that portfolio. Nag-short sell ka, but you have the stock. But if you do not have the stock when you short sell, ibig sabihin nun, naked option naman ang tawag dun. No, naked, ha? So, kaya ganun ang definition niya. Covered option, an option written against stock held on investor's portfolio. But when it is naked, uncovered option, an option written without the stock to back it up. No? So, meaning, yun nga, nag-short sell ka ng stock. Now, if you have the stock, now then it is covered. But if you do not have the stock, then it is naked. Ha? So yung short selling papasok dyan. Okay? But short selling is just one of the examples. Pero that is, I think, the easiest way to explain your short selling. So you're selling that at a higher price and then you buy at a lower price. Now, if you have the stock, covered. But if you do not have the stock, then it is naked. Naliwanag ba yan? Is it clear, class?
Yes po, sir.
Okay, so call option. Meron pa rin tayong terminology na in the money at saka out of the money. So when you say in the money, the current price is greater than the strike price. And then when you say out of the money, the current price is less than the strike price. Now, under the put option, baliktad. Yung in the money at saka out of the money. because the strike price is greater than the current price. And then the out of the money, the strike price, the current price is greater than the strike price. Okay? Now, these options, normally they are short term. No, six months, 9 months, no, basta short term siya. But if you want to have a longer term, then you have the lips. No, ito na siya. We have these lips. Now, similar to normal options, but they are longer options with maturities of up to 2.5 years. Huh? So, longer options lang yan. Yung mga kanina diniscuss natin, mga short term, no? Kasi 6 months yung example ko. So, when it is longer, so you have the longer or long-term equity anticipation securities or LIPS. Okay, example tayo, tignan natin. So we have the call, and then we have the put. Okay, so which is in the money there under the call option? Let's say this one alone. You have the last price, which is the current price of the stock. And then you have the strike price or the exercise price of the stock. Which is in the, this one is what? Is it in the money or out of the money? Huh? Okay, Alaya.
In the money po.
Okay, that is in the money. Because the last price or the current price is greater than the strike price. So this one is in the money. Okay? But these two, that is the OTM, no? Yan yung out of the money. Okay? Because this time, the last price is less than the strike price. Now, what about here in the put option? Alin dito yung in the money? So, baliktad naman siya, no? Lalabas dito, ang in the money, nandito. Ayan yung in the money natin. Kasi yung in the money natin, the strike price is greater than the last price or the current price of the stock. So, ito mas mataas kesa dito. Okay? Now, this one will be the out of the money. Okay ba yan? Kasi baliktad sila ni call option. Next tayo, no? So, determining option exercise value and option premium. So, I think, actually, kanina definition din natin, no? Yung, ito, no? Yung exercise value. The exercise value is actually the full name is the exercise value of the option yan. Ha? So, yun yun, current stock price minus the strike price. So, huwag kayong malilito minsan sa mga terminologies, ano? Pagka sinabi natin stock price, that is also the current price. When you say strike price, that is also the exercise price. Ha? So, to compute for the exercise value of the option, you get the difference between the stock price and the strike price. So, 25 minus 25, 0. 30 minus 25, 5, no? Then 35 minus 25, 10. So, yung computation ng exercise value of the option. Now, the market price of the option, they are given, lalabas given to. And then, to compute for the option premium, you get the difference between the two. No? The market price minus the exercise value of the option. So, that is 3. No? And then we have 750, minus 5 to 50. Then 12 minus 10, 2. 1650 minus 15, 1.5. So that is the option premium. Now the difference between the market price of the option and the exercise value of the option. So kung titignan niyo class, habang tumataas yung exercise, ay yung stock price natin, now yung exercise value of the option also increases. That is, if the strike price is constant. Huh? So, makikita nyo yung stock price natin, nag-increase. The exercise value also increases. No? And because of that, no, yung option premium natin, dumiliit naman. No, dumiliit. Yan yung mga relationships nila. No, dumiliit naman siya. Okay? Okay, so factors that affect the value of a call option. So one is the higher the stock's price in relation to the strike price, the higher the call option price. And then the higher the strike price, the lower the call option price. So baliktad lang to, syempre, no? Baliktad lang yan. And then the longer the option period, the higher the option price. So saan naman ang galing yun? So dito. So the longer the period, the higher the option price. So kaya dito, pagdating ng September, 6.6. October is 8.10. January is 11.20. So the same thing with the put option, no? 2.99, 4.3, 6.9. So sinasabi nga na rito, the longer the option period, the higher the option price. So an option on an extremely volatile stock is worth more than an option on a very stable stock. So mataas pala yung price ng option for a volatile stock. And then the price of a call option always increase as the risk-free rate increases. And you know what is a risk-free, di ba? So we are referring to the treasury bill rate when we say risk-free. So as this interest rate goes up, now the price of the call option also goes up. Clear ba yan? Okay, now let's go to the computation of the Black-Scholes option pricing model. Okay, so by the way, all of this information, I got it from Brigham, no? Si Brigham ang ginagamit natin kasi yung book. Although some of the explanations, I took it from my book, no? Pero nandun din naman sa book ni Brigham yun. So, the underlying stock, or the stock underlying the call option pays no dividends during the call option's life. So again, these are the assumptions. Now, there are no transaction costs for the sale purchase of either the stock of the option. Ang dami niyang assumptions, ano? And then unlimited borrowing and selling at a short-term risk-free rate, which is known and constant. Then no penalty for short selling, and sellers receive immediately full cash proceeds at today's price. Then actually dito sa Philippines, bawal yung short selling. Wala pa tayong short selling, no? Pero PSE is now trying to propose to have short selling here in the country. At sana naman talaga magkaroon ng short selling plus. Ako, I'm hoping for that also. Since I'm always investing in the stock market, so I hope that there is also short selling. Okay, then option can only be exercised on its expiration date. Kasi options, there are two kinds of options also, no? One is the European option, and the other one is the American option. So what we are explaining here are all based on European option. So meaning it can only be exercised on the expiration date. Because the American option, it can be exercised even before the expiration date. Yun ang pagkakaiba nila. So in our lessons here, all are European option, ha? Then security trading takes place in continuous time, and stock prices move randomly in continuous time. Okay, so how to compute for the Black-Scholes option pricing model? Or how to use, no, the Black-Scholes option pricing model? So we have the D1 and D2. So for the D1 and D2, we have to get the normal distribution of D1 and the D2. So, kaya meron tayong ND1 at saka ND2. So, that represent areas under a standard normal distribution function. So, we have the D1 and the D2. And then we have the LN, which is the lag normal of the price and the current price and the exercise price, no? Then we have the risk-free rate, the variance. 2 is constant, and then we have the time. And then we have the standard deviation, and then we have the square root of time. So that is to compute for the D1. And then for the D2, we have D1 minus the standard deviation multiplied by the square root of time. So once you obtain this, now we will look at the table. Yung normal distribution natin. And then we will have now the computation for the V, which is the value of the option. So we have the price times the normal distribution D1. Then we have the exercise price. Then we have the E, which the value is constant, which is 2.7183. And then multiplied by, there is an exponent, by the way, which is negative risk-free rate times the time. And then you multiply them to ND2, by your normal distribution two. So for the example, so let's see, we have the price, which is 27. That is the current price of the stock. The exercise is 25, exercise price, 25. The risk-free rate is 6%, 0.5 for the P, and the variance is 0.11. Now to compute for the D1, we have the log normal of 27 over 25, that is P over X, no? Yan yung numerator natin, P, denominator is X, plus 0.06, which is the risk-free rate. Then we have the 0.11, which is the variance, then constant 2, and then we have the time. And the 0.3317 is the standard deviation of 0.11, and the 0.7071 is the square root of P. No? So based on that, we can get 0.5736. And then for the D2, we have the 0.5736, ito yung balian, no? And then we have the 0.3317, which is again the standard deviation. And then we have the square root of T, no? 0.7071. And we can get the 0.3391. So once you obtain this, ayan, so we have to look for the MD1 and MD2. Okay, so dito siya. Pakita natin yung table naman, no? Okay, so yan. Nilagay ko na rin dito para hindi tayo nalilito, no? Okay, so let's start with the 0.5736. Ito yung nakuha natin for the D1. And this is the one we obtained using the D2. Okay, so for the 0.5736, meron tayong 0.5. Same 0.5 nandito class. Ito, nasa ilalim. Nakikita nyo? Hindi ko malagyan kasi parang picture ko siya nilagay eh, no? Ito, 0.5. Nakita nyo class? Can you say yes?
Yes.
Only ito yung 5, no? 0.5. And then we have the 0.5 then followed by 7. Diba? So 0.5, we have the 0.7, this one, 0.07, and 0.5. Okay, so we have the 0.2157, but we have the 0.36, a 0.0036. So the 0.0036 must be between 0.07 and 0.08. So we have to do a little interpolation, no? So we have now the 0.2190, then 0.2157, no? You get the difference, and then multiply by 0.36. Okay, so makukuha natin. So the 0.5 is based on the normal distribution, so constant yung 0.5. And then we have the 0.2157, which is the this one, 0.2157 na yan. And then we have the 0.2190, you know yung difference nila. And then times 0.36. So you would get the 0.71688, no? And then for the 0.3391, we have again the 0.3, ito. And then we have the 0.003. So we have the 0.1293, ito siya, no? But we have the 91. So the 91 should be between 0.03 and 0.04. Kaya, nandito siya ngayon, no? So we have the 0.1331. Ito rin kasi yun. And then the 0.1.293, ito yun. and then multiply by 0.91. No? So, makukuha natin, once added the 0.1293, and this one again is constant for the normal distribution. So we can get 0.6327. So that is now the normal distribution for D1 and D2. Maliwanag ba yung class? Is it clear?
Sir, sa quiz din po ba mag-i-interpolation po kami?
Lalabas. Hindi ko alam kung dapat ibigay na lang yung ND1 sino yung ND2. No? Tingnan natin kung paano gagawin. Hindi natin alam kung sino magiging examiner. Eh. Pero kung ako yung magiging examiner, siguro ibibigay ko na yung D1 and D2. Tapos, ibibigay ko rin yung ND1 and ND2. So, pipilihan nyo ninyo kung anong dapat gamitin doon. Ha?
Okay po, sir. Thank you po.
Para alam nyo rin kung dapat paano gamitin yung table. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, this time we have na ito. Diba, nakuha na natin siya? Tama ba yun? Okay. Oh, tama, no? Okay, so we can now proceed to the computation. So, based on that, you have the price, which is 27. Times the normal distribution of 0.7168 minus the exercise price, and then we have the exponent, which is 2.7183, then with the exponent negative 0.06 multiplied by 0.5, and then we have the normal distribution 2, which is 0.6327. So therefore, the value of the option using the Black-Scholes option pricing model is 4.0036. Okay, maliwanag ba yan? Class?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so next. Now let's go to the riskless hedge. So what is a riskless hedge? So this is a hedge in which an investor buys a stock and simultaneously sells a call option on that stock and ends up with a riskless position. So riskless position, so meaning whether the price, no, of the underlying asset or the portfolio goes up or goes down, there will be no risk on the part of the company. Kaya nga riskless position. So in particular, ito yon. So if the stock's price increases, the investor will earn a profit on the stock but will lose money from selling the call option. So ibig sabihin lang yung class, if you, let's say, buy the stock or you bought the stock, you will sell also a call option. So para kahit nalimbawa tumaas yung price ng stock mo, kumita ka ron, yun nga lang, malulugi ka naman dun sa selling mo. Kasi opposite direction yan eh, no? Opposite direction. Diba sinabi natin, when you buy a call option, you're expecting that the price of the stock will go up or the underlying asset will go up. Diba? Ganon. But this one, you will sell. You're the one selling the call option. But you bought that stock and then you sell the call option. So if the price of the stock goes up, kumita ka rito. But you lose on your call option. But let's say the price of the stock goes down. Nalugi ka rito, pero kumita ka naman dito sa call option mo for selling. So kaya, kumbaga, nagaan sila, meron silang opposite directions, di ba, na nangyayari. So, it becomes what? A riskless hedge. So, that explains yung riskless hedge. So, how to do it? Ito ang gagawin natin ngayon. Gagawa tayo ng riskless hedge. Okay, so, create a riskless hedge to determine the value of a call option. So, this one, we have the stock sells for $15 per share. And the option will expire in 6 months. So yun yung expiration date naman natin, no? At which time the stock will be selling at one of two prices, 10 or 20. So ibig sabihin nun, in 6 months, in 6 months, no? In 6 months, yung $15 natin na yun, no? Maaaring pumunta rin siya sa 10, sa 20, or it will go down to, will go down to 10. No? It's either it will go up to 20 or go down to 10. So yun yung kanya. So actually ito, tawag nga rito yung ito class binomial eh. Kasi dalawa lang eh. Dalawa lang expectations ng price, no? It's either 20 or 10. Ha? So, but at the same time, since meron kang the stock sells for 15, so bumili ka ng stock lumalabas nito, and then you will sell the call option. So, what steps are we going to undertake? So, ito yung mga musunod na steps. So, one, find the range of values at expiration. So, for the first step, find the range of values at expiration. So, we have the ending stock price. So, ito kasi yun. Then, expectation natin. So, 10 and 20, the difference is 10. Then the strike price is 15. 15, 15. So, syempre, kung halimbawa, yung bumili ka ng stock, tapos you sell the call option, the price is 15. Diba? So, let's say the price of the stock was up to 20, still the strike price will be 15. Diba? Pero yung option value natin, ano? So, if the strike price is 15, which is greater than the ending stock, ending stock price, then you will let the strike price to expire. Now, ibig sabihin, yung buyer ng call option, no, will let that to expire. Kasi, bumaba yung price, but you exercise yung buying, so 15, when the price is at 10. So, it becomes worthless to us, no? So, zero. Huh? Now, if let's say the price is 15, no? And then, of course, the other party, no, will exercise his right to buy. So, yung difference itong dalawa is 5. Huh? So, kaya 5 minus 0, 5. Ito, yung difference kasi nito, hindi natin pwede gawing negative. No? Because, pagka nag-exercise, hindi ka nag-exercise, it's either 0 or 5 or 15 lang yan. Wala. Pagka si strike price, no? Sa ano tawag dito? Sa call option value. So, kaya ba ano mangyari? Magiging worthless yung value ng option dyan sa company value, no? Kaya, 0 lang yan. Hindi pwede mag-negative. Hanggang 0 lang. Okay, but this one is 5. Okay? Next, no, equalize the range of payoffs for the stock and option. So how to equalize? By the way, dito pala tayo, no? So 5 divided by 10. No, makuha natin is 5 divided by 10. So that is 0.5. So ano ibig sabihin ng 0.5 na yan? No, the 0.5 means that we will have to sell 0.5 shares or share and selling one call option. So sell tayo ng 0.5 stock or share and then sell one call option. So yun yung para maging English. No, sell 0.5 for the stock. Buy 0.5 for the stock and then sell one call option. Nakuha niya? Gets, plus? So, ulitin ko, ha? So, we have the 0.5 here at saka 10. No? So, you divide 5 and 10. So, we have the 0.5 now. So, what is the action to be undertaken by the company? So, one is selling, one is buying, another one is selling. So, for the buying, you buy 0.5. Ibig sabihin, no? 0.5. So, kung halimbawa bibili ka ng stock na 0.5, halimbawa, ibenta mo naman na call option, isa. Kung halimbawa bumili ka ng 100,000 shares, no? 100,000 ang binili mo, magbenta ka naman ng 200,000 na call option. So yun yung ibig sabihin ng 0.5 na yan. Okay? To create this riskless hedge. Okay? So anyway, yun yung sinasabi ng 0.5 na yan. So this time, equalize the range of the payoffs for the stock and the option. So we have the 10 times 0.5, so 5. And then the 20 times 0.5, 10. Diba? Pero yung ending value ng option natin, 0 and 5. So saan nagaling yan? Ito yung 0 and 5. Never na magne-negative 5 yan. Ha? Walang negative dyan sa part na yan, sa step na yan. Okay? So it's either the option will be exercised or not. So in this case, it will not exercise, but this one, it will exercise. So there's a difference of 20 minus 15, kaya 5 value lalabas. Ha? Yan yung exercise value of the option lumalabas. Okay? Kasi yan yung difference. Eh. So pagdating rito sa ending option niya, 0 and 5. Now the next step is create a riskless hedge investment. So this time we have again yung 10 times 0.5, ito nga yung 0.5, and then 20 times 0.5, 10. So the ending value of the option now is, for this one is 0. 0 pa rin siya. But this time, magkakaroon na tayo ng negative. Now, bakit? Kasi once the price, no, let's say, goes up to 20 nga, eh, we sold a call option. Diba? We sold a call option. So, ibig sabihin, yung buyer ng call option naman will exercise the right to buy at 15 because the strike price is 15. So, kung yung 15 na yon, so just imagine, selling at 15 when the price of the stock is 20. So, nagkaroon tayo ng loss na 5. Kaya nagkaroon tayo ng negative 5 dito ngayon, no? So, if you notice now, the portfolio now, no, the value of the portfolio is 5. Now, whether it goes up to it goes up to 20 or it goes down to 10, the value of the portfolio now is 5. So, importante ito lalabas na yun, na equal yan, 5 na yan ng value ng portfolio natin. Just follow the steps, hindi kayo mawawala dyan plus. At hindi man mahirap eh, kaya you follow the steps. You follow the steps. Now, you obtain this, no? Nakuha na natin ngayon ito. So, this time, we calculate the present value of the riskless portfolio today. So, this 5, came from this one. Oh, yan. So, kahit anong piliin mo dyan, okay lang, because it is the same. So, 5. And then, we get the present value of that 5. So, we have the 1 plus this free rate, then time is, ilang months nga ba yun? 5 months ba? 6 months, no? Ilang months nga yun? Kalimutan ko, sandali, ah. So, time is 0.5, so 6 months nga, no? 6 months. Okay, ito lalabas ay 1.0. Ano nga yung risk? Ano nga yung rate natin? Risk free is 6%. 0.6. Then we have the 0.5. No? So yan yung denominator natin. Lumalabas, no? So we will get now 4.86 for the present value. Now next, we have the calculate the cost of the stock in the portfolio. So, lumalabas, dahil nga 0.5 yung ating yung ratio natin. So, the price of the stock now 15. So, makukuha natin is 7.5. So, 0.5 times 15, you will get 7.5. And then get the difference. You have the 7.5, the cost of the stock. And then you have the present value of the portfolio. Then you have that 2.64, which is the price of the option. So when you buy the option, so ibig sabihin dapat 2.64 para magkaroon kayo ng riskless hedge. So just follow the steps, class. No, walang problema dyan. Just follow the steps and you know the information or the data given to you and you will not be lost. No? Hindi kayo maliligaw dyan. Basta susundan nyo lang step by step nyo. Okay, clear ba yung class? Question?
None so far.
Oh, Okay, so next, let's get to the next, no? Meron pa tayong mga concepts, no? So ito yung mga, ano na lang, sa mga factors that affect a call option's value. So this one is a call, no? Call option. So dito sa part na to, no? That is only the same with your put option. Same yan sa put option. But the put and the call option will only differ when it comes to this one. Now, for the current stock price, when it increases, the option value increases. If the risk-free rate increases, the option value will also increase. The exercise price, once it increases, then it will decrease for the option value. Kasi kinukuha natin lagi yung difference nito at saka nito. Diba? So natural, kung tumaas ito, tataas ito. Pagka ito naman na tumaas, bababa naman ito. Kasi we always compute the difference between the two. Okay? Now, when it comes to the put option, pagdating sinabi ko, pareho lang sila rito ng call option. But when it comes to the put option on this part, it is the opposite. Okay? It is the opposite. Because we will only exercise the value of the stock now if the price went down. Huh? So when the current stock price increases, so decrease. Pero pag ito naman nag-increase, mag-increase naman yun. No? And then yun nga, yung risk-free rate decrease, which is exactly opposite to call option. So kasi ito yung call option natin. You know, increase, increase, decrease. But on the part of the put option, decrease, decrease, then increase. No? Okay, so let's go to the forward and futures contracts. So forward contract, one party agrees to buy a commodity at a specific price on a future date, and the counterparty agrees to make the sale. So there is physical delivery of the commodity. So yun yung binanggit ko kanina, di ba? There is a physical delivery of forward contract or the underlying asset under the forward contract. But the futures contract is standardized exchange-traded contracts in which physical delivery of the underlying asset does not actually occur, no? But only the difference in price. Kaya pagdating sa drawing, no? Let's say drawing natin yan. So let's say sa forward and contracts naman tayo, ha? A forward and futures. So actually, parang ganito siya in the end. Naku, hindi pa nakuha. Drawing na lang natin ulit. Pareho lang naman actually ang drawing nila, no? Ganyan din siya. So, ganyan din yung drawing naman kung forward or futures contract yan. No? Forward or futures yan. Pareho lang ang drawing nila, no? This time, for the forward and the futures, obligation mo nang bayaran. No, kanina, for the options, it is the right to buy or right to sell. But this one, it is an obligation to settle the difference. So, kaya kung meron din silang exercise price, for example, here, or agreed price, no, for the delivery, let's say 75. Or let's say na lang, ikaw pa rin yung coffee farmer bale, no? And then you are selling your coffee beans in 6 months. Sabi mo nga, I cannot sell my coffee beans lower than 75. Kasi lugi ako yan. But at 75, I will have a decent profit. Sabi mo gano'n. So, there is a buyer and there is a seller of the forward contract or the futures contract. So, if the price went up to 100, no, but because you entered into a contract of 75, you are obligated to sell the contract or the forward contract or the coffee bean at 75, even if the price is already 100. Diba? Ang pagkakaiba niya dun sa kanina, you have the option to let the option to expire or exercise. But this one, no. No? Kung bawang 75 and you entered into a contract for the delivery price of 75, so if the price goes up to 100, no, then you lose. Kasi 100 pesos yun. So instead of selling it at 100, you will just sell that at 75. No? But let's see the price goes down to 50. No? That's a 50 siya ngayon. And so this time, you gain. Bakit? Kasi, just imagine for the coffee that cost 50 pesos in the market, let's say, you can sell that at 75. Kasi yun ang contract. Ang nalugi naman dyan, yung siyempre, yung kabilang side, no? Yung yung nag-enter na contract sa'yo. Because you entered into a contract to sell your coffee beans at 75. But the other one, dito pala ay buy pala tayo rito. Sorry, baliktad yung aking ano. So anyway, dito, coffee bean, bali ulit yung ano ha, nasabi ko yung sell. Kasi dapat ito ay buy. No? But anyway, ganun din naman yun eh. So kung 75 yan, no? Pagka umakit itong 100, because you entered into a contract of 75, we have to sell that at 75, even if the price is at 100. But if the price went down to 50, now still, you will sell that at 75, even if the price is at 50. So, ganun siya lumalabas. So, yung forward or futures contract. But only the difference between the forward or the futures is that for the futures, it has a standardized exchange. Unlike for the forwards, there is none. No, pero sa banko, merong forward contracts. Kasi nung nasa banko ako, nakita ko yung forward contracts. No, but for the futures, I do not know if we have an exchange here in the Philippines for the futures. Ha? So, ganun. Naintindihan niyo ba, class? So, class, hello? Nakuha niyo? Nakuha niyo? Yung last topic natin is actually ito. Swap options naman. No, swap option. So let's say we have in company A located in the Philippines. And then it's paying, let's say, fixed rate for the interest. No? And then let's say we have company B located in the US and they are paying floating rate. So this one, the obligation is, let's say, 500M. And then this one is also, syempre, dapat equivalent sa 500M. Also, let's say, lalabas parang 100 US and then naka 10 lang yun, 10, no? 10 US dollars lalabas yan. So lalabas, equal pa rin sila, no? Considering, let's say, that the exchange rate is 50 pesos per dollar. So, lagyan natin dito para mas maliwanag, ha? 50 US dollars. Mm-hmm. Bawa, ganyan. 50 pesos per 1 US dollar, no? So, lalabas, 500 million din to. So, sabi ni company in the Philippines, we are in a fixed rate. No? Sabi ganyan. But I think, it is better if it is floating rate for us, sabi ni company A, na nasa Philippines. Because the interest rate is going down. So, if you are fixed, kahit na mababa yung interest rate, mataas yung binabayaran natin ng interest, sabi nila. So I think it is better for us to be a floating rate. Now, on the other hand, the company in US, they are paying at floating rate. Huh? But the interest rate in the US is increasing. So sabi nang ganun, I think it is better for us to have a fixed rate. So even if the fixed rate is pegged at a high rate, But once the interest rate goes up, no higher than the fixed rate, we still pay at fixed rate, sabi niya naman. So we are better at fixed rate, sabi nito. So this time, they will have an agreement to swap, no? To swap. They are swap options ang tawag nila. So they will agree now that the Philippines will pay floating rate. And then the other one, they agreed that they will pay at fixed rate. But again, no, they will only pay based on the difference of the fixed rate and floating rate. So this time, Company A now is paying based on floating rate, but before it was fixed rate. And then Company B was paying before at floating rate, but now it is at fixed rate. But the difference between the two, yun lang yung settlement nilang dalawa. Na settlement lang nila. The difference between the fixed rate and the floating rate. And then of course, there should be a basis. You know, magkakonsila dapat ang basis. Maaaring gamitin nila ang basis ay yung LIBOR rate, LIBOR, or the SIBOR. So there should be a base for the interest rate. So it may be the LIBOR rate or it may be the SIBOR rate. Kaya yan ang tinawag natin swap option naman plus, no? Okay, so okay, hanggang dyan na lang tayo, no? Tapos na tayo, balik class. So for the rest, you can read them already, ha? Okay, may question kayo? Clarification plus?
Sir, meron po pala. Okay. Then po sa may